Good morning. My name is Wayne Perahudoff. I'm from Medicine Hat, Alberta, Canada. Applied for and received stem cell treatment for heart muscle regeneration. My heart history started over 10 years ago with a heart attack. In the meantime, after that, last year, or the year before, I should say, I have an ICD, implantable cardioverter pacemaker, defibrillator, pardon me. And so with that, I did some research, and on the recommendation of my family physician, he said I'd be a good candidate for stem cell therapy. Last July. Well, probably the biggest thing, in considering that I've been on heart medications for over 10 years, is that I've made no more trips to the emergency department, no more emergency medevacs, no more visits to the ICU department. So that's important for me, that my disease or situation hasn't been deteriorating and progressing worse. So that's a real positive to me. I've also had no bouts of chest pain. No problem walking. I've taken no shots of nitroglycerin. And that is typically a medical indicator of, like usually your family doctor or cardiologist will say, oh, how many times have you used nitro in the past month? And that's an indicator to them how good or bad your situation is. So I've used zero nitroglycerin, so that's another positive. Generally speaking, I had a lot more energy. I can get by with less sleep. Feel more alert, never had any tightness in my chest, no trouble breathing. So a lot of really good things. Family doctor was probably the most aware about stem cell therapy. He felt it was cutting edge technology. He actually just came from a conference in the United States. Now, so we can't get it in North America. But he said, because I don't have deterioration of other body systems, he's, you know, I got one major problem, that's my heart muscle, that I would be a really good candidate for this. So that's why he recommended it. So he is definitely very pro towards this new technology. The other physicians, notably the specialists, i.e. be it the internists or the cardiologists, it's difficult for them to believe that there has been improvement. It was mentioned to me that, well, medications do a lot to help my heart patients, and probably that's the main cause. My response was, well, I've been on heart medications for 10 years, all that got me was a implanted defibrillator, another heart attack, and another two trips to the Foothills Hospital ICU. I don't consider that progression positive. And I said it would be rather synonymous that statistically I come back from Thailand in July, suddenly my echocardiogram shows that my EF factor or my EF fraction has improved, and physically the physician who assessed it, a Canadian doctor in a Canadian hospital, said that the bottom third of my left ventricle has regenerated. Also, I have a shortened PR interval, less PVCs, less or slower heart rate, all very positive. And that's noted by a Canadian physician in a Canadian hospital. So I mentioned that, I mean, there is measurable proof of it. And same as myself, I mean, hey, I'd like to know, I'd like to see some numbers, and that's great. So I think they're slowly coming around, but they're still hesitant because it's still the old school. Well, a typical heart patient takes 6 or 7 medications, right, on a standard, and they're doomed pretty much to take it for the rest of their life. Yeah, it was about 4 or 5 months later. My first one was 25% to 30%. Yep. The second one, the new one after stem cell therapy, was 30% to 35%. So statistically, if a normal EF is 50, mine went up basically 10%, which is, hey, things noticeable, like climbing stairs, way easier, hauling up groceries, way easier, whereas before it was a bit of a chore. I guess because I have more energy, then I'm more prone towards, I'll go for a walk, Whereas before, I was kind of lazy. And so, or at the very least, I wouldn't walk as far. So definitely much better towards. I'm just much more watchful now about my medications. I hope to come off some of the medications soon, talking to the physicians. And I used to be a pre-diabetic. That's not really applicable anymore. So that's also good news. And have a very positive attitude now. And I guess if anything I can say about the stem cell therapy, it does offer hope to heart patients. Because if all that's out there is really medications or a triple heart bypass, I mean, heaven forbid, I don't want to get my chest torn open. It offers hope for alternative, really simple, non-invasive, and it offers hope for those patients. And I hope that we could, in the future, save more people in Canada.